डॉक्टर संदीप कडू सर. ही इज अ प्रोफेसर एंड हेड ऑफ द डिपार्टमेंट डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फॉरेंसिक मेडिसिन एंड टॉक्सिकोलॉजी, डॉक्टर विठ्ठलराव विखे पाटील फाउंडेशन मेडिकल कॉलेज अहमदनगर. सर इज वेरी एक्टिव मेंबर ऑफ एमईटी एंड ऑल्सो द रिसर्च डिपार्टमेंट. ही हैज मेनी पेटेंट्स कॉपीराइट ऑन हिज नेम एंड ही इज अ ट्रेंडिंग टीचर ऑन यूट्यूब ऑल्सो. मेनी पीपल दे फॉलो फॉर हिज लेक्चर्स एंड आई एम हैप्पी टू शेयर विथ यू ऑल दैट रिसेंटली ही गॉट अ पेटेंट फॉर इंडियाज फर्स्ट ऑनलाइन फॉरेंसिक म्यूजियम एंड फॉर दैट वी कॉन्ग्रेचुलेट हिम. एंड टूडे ही इज गोइंग टू डिलीवर अ लेक्चर ऑन इंट्रोडक्शन टू इफेक्टिव कम्युनिकेशन स्किल्स. आई होप एवरी वन विल एंजॉय द लेक्चर. सर कडू सर ओवर टू यू.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. At the onset, I am very thankful to Honorable Deputy Director Dr. Abhijit Dutte, sir, Principal Dr. Shyam Ganvir, sir, Organizing Secretary Dr. Swarna Ganvir, madam, and Organizing Coordinator Dr. Deepak Anam for giving me opportunity to deliver session on Introduction to Effective Communication Skills. So you are today's workshop topic is the resident as a teacher, but my topic is not related to your as a teacher responsibility, but it is related to overall your professional life. So communication skill, it is required not only your professional life, your personal life, family life. And many problems in our day-to-day life arises due to lack of communication. We always say there is communication gap. So if you are able to get or deliver effective communication to other person, then you will be 100% successful in your life. So with this keynote, I'll start my topic on Introduction to Effective Communication Skill. My session will be an interactive session. So first, I will test your knowledge about the communication. So Kohli madam, can you tell what is communication? What do you understood by the word communication?
Interaction between two people.
Good. Shubham, Shubham Tokar.
Sir, it's an interaction between whether it in either in two peoples or in a group.
Okay. Then Toshant Bakkar.
So it is the exchange of ideas and information between teacher, student, and many peoples.
Okay, okay. So you are given answer which is not up to the mark, but you are on the line. So at first we will see the definition of the communication. So the communication, some technical problem is there. My slide is not moving. So Wikipedia definition of the communication is what you all told correctly, that it is the process. So remember, it is the process. And what allows? It allows interact with other people. So without it, we would not able to share our knowledge, experience, or anything outside of ourselves. So that the importance or that the meaning of the communication. So the process of the communication is what allows to interact with other people. Without it, we would be unable to share knowledge or experiences with anything outside of ourselves. So that's the important part of the communication. And how, what are the different forms of the communication? These are speaking, writing, gestures, touch, and broadcasting. So my session's objective are to consider verbal and non-verbal communication method to understand and practice effective listening skills and to communicate in clear, respectful, and non-judgmental ways. So these are the important objective of my today's session. So next, see this video and afterwards carefully. Afterwards, I'm going to ask you a question about it is related to the communication. See it carefully. So my question to Sumita Sugan, so what you understood from this video related to the communication? Yes, Sumita madam, have you seen this video?
Yes sir.
Communication, what message you got from this video?
Oh, not audible.
I'm again repeating. Have you seen this video?
Yes, sir.
Then what message related to today's topic, that is communication, you got from seeing this video? Tell me. You are from which college?
So, Government Medical College, Nagpur.
Okay. Yeah. Have you attentive?
Yes, sir.
Then tell me the message. What message you got related to the communication by seeing this video?
So while communicating, we have to be a little bit patient also, be empathy when we are talking to somebody.
Then Yamini, what you got the message?
Hello. Sir, the qualities which were described, what a doctor should have, like focus, empathy, compassion, optimism, this all things, this requires communication. While communicating, doctor-patient relation should have nice communication to be a good doctor. Communication is required much.
Okay. Dr. Neha, I'm asking or giving you a hint. In this video, have you heard any word?
No, sir.
Yes, still, have you got the message? What the previous speaker has that the doctor require different qualities. Have you got all these things?
Yes, sir.
Without any word, only by seeing, only by the expression, you got whatever they want to give the message about the doctors. Is it clear? So I have shown you this video that without speaking any word, you can communicate. So there are two types of the communication, that is verbal and non-verbal. So what do you think? Which is more important, verbal or non-verbal?
Verbal.
Non-verbal.
Any other answer?
So, non-verbal.
So we most commonly use non-verbal.
Non-verbal, most commonly we use.
Non-verbal. Okay, you are right. That most of the time, non-verbal communication is very important. So, I want to give by showing this video that message that with a non-verbal, without speaking anything, you can give the correct message. Is it clear? Then, if there is verbal, then what and how your voice affect the communication? What could be your physical attributes affect your communication and power of touch? So, communication is series of the experience of a different spatial senses. What are our spatial senses? Hearing, smelling, seeing, tasting, touching. These are the spatial senses. And with these spatial senses, we can communicate effectively with other person. Up till now, clear? So what is, in a total communication process, 45% is listening. And I'm going to give or insist on a listening. Nowadays, we don't listen. And if we don't listen, then there is communication gap or there is not effective communication. So in a communication process, 45% importance is to the listening, 30% is speaking, 9% is writing, and 16% is the reading. Now, with this, what is the communication equation? So 40% of the message we hear, 50% of the message we see with your expressions and other facial gestures, etc. And 10% is with the word. So this is the communication equation. Now I'm concentrating here on, as your workshop is a resident, as a teacher, So as a teacher, what quality should be in you for your effective communication with your student, with your patient, with the relative of the patient, with your colleagues, with your seniors? So with this communication equation, if you use all these hearing, seeing, and the word proper, then you will communicate effectively with all your stakeholders related to the academics. So what do you hear? In that, your tone of voice should be that there should be high pitch, low pitch. So you should vary your tone according to the important thing. Then vocal clarity should be there. Then verbal expressiveness should be there. So these are the important thing related to the hearing. Now, when you are in front of your student taking any lecture, your facial expressions, or if you are in a tension, then your facial expression will be different, and student also get that you are in a tension, and also it affects your proper communication. So use proper facial expression. Then as your teacher, as well as your doctor, so the society sees you next to God. So you wear the dress, it should be a proper dress. So you in front of the student,
sir, you are not audible.
Yes. Sir, you are not audible. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
You are again on mute.
Sir, you are again on mute.
Now, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Sorry for the technical difficulties. Then your facial expression should be proper. Your dress, you should wear a decent dress, because many times now you are teaching to the adult student. At that time, whatever the thing, because you want to give or proper deliver the proper message to your student, so you should give a importance to your content, and you should be a properly decent dress. Many times in our college days, we always used to see how was lecture. Then our friends will say that lecture was nice to see. So you can understand that whenever you are taking lecture, or you are giving treatment to the patient, as a doctor, you should wear a decent dress. Posture, proper posture should be used, and there should be eye-to-eye contact. I'm saying that eye-to-eye confident contact should be there. There should not be any staring. So there is the difference between the staring and the eye-to-eye contact. So as a doctor, as a teacher, because we are much more respected personality in the society, so we have to behave like that only. Touch. Whenever you are touching patient, you should take care. And it is very important to the male doctor, when you are touching to the female patient, at that time, you have to take care that some female attendant should be there when you are examining any female patient. Gesture. You should use a proper gesture. So all these things should be carefully maintained while you are communicating to all the stakeholders related to the academy, and use proper word. So official language always should be used. So non-official language should not be used in front of the patient or in front of your student or in your day-to-day life. You should always use good words. So all these things you should remember about when you are delivering the message. So by hearing 40%, by seeing and feeling 50% and only 10% is for the words. Now, again, I am showing a video to you. Here again, that boy has read on a blackboard that if you want something from your bottom of the heart, you will get it 100%. So that little schoolboy has read that thing on a blackboard that if you want something from your bottom of the heart, you will get it. But that boy is confused. Is it really possible in our real life that what we want, really we get it? Then he goes to his teacher and asks, sir, I have read like this and I'm confused. Really? I will get that? Then what answer his teacher gives, please see. And after that, again, I'm going to ask the question. Yes, Twinkle, what your message got from this video? Twinkle Kundani?
So from this video...
What message you got related to the communication?
Sir, I got this message ki even though we are not achieving our goal in the first row, we should not stop trying.
Okay, that message is from the video. Understood. But related to the communication, what you understood?
Sir, the way we talk to our patients, yeah, if I am teaching a student, the way I interact with them, like the motivation that I give to my students will be important.
Okay. The message, the answer I want, that there is without words, also with action, and with giving some day-to-day life experience, you can give or motivate your student. So the student has read it. Ask to his teacher that really he gets what he wants, but he has not understood. When he understood the importance, when that coin was tossed, and after tossing, he got that message that for anything you want to successful in the life, you have to do the your hard work. You will be unsuccessful for first attempt, second attempt, third attempt, but at last you will be successful in your life. But this was communicated not with a word. It was communicated by some experiment. That's the thing. That message I want to give you. Have understood? All of you understood?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So today's session, we are going to consider that the communication is the two-way process. What is effective communication skill and what are the barriers of an effective communication skill? So for any communication, what are the two important things? Anybody? What are the two important things related to the communication? Shimaz Khan. Shimaz? So what are the two important process in a communication?
Yes, sir.
What are important communication process in the communication? Do you know it?
Sir, speaking and listening.
Good.
Sir, verbal and non-verbal.
No. One is speaking and listening.
Listening.
So these are the two things. In other word, there is sender and another is receiver. And you have to, sender has to, now you all are listener or receiver and I am a sender. Understood? And I want to give some message to you related to the communication. So these two important things or these two important persons should be there. One should be sender and one should be the receiver. And both should be active. And then only there will be the effective communication. Is it clear? So for effective communication, these two persons, that sender and receiver. And sender is that I am sender now in today's session. And you are receiver. And both should be active. That's why for the activeness, I'm asking you questions in between. Because otherwise, you will start your video, chit-chat, and there is nothing. Only the for certificate purpose, you will attend. So that should not be the thing. Understood? So in a communication process, there is sender and a receiver. And there are barriers related to the communication skill. So we'll see in the next slide. First, what are the effective communication skill? And for the effective communication skill, you should have eye-to-eye contact. There should be a positive body language. The surrounding should be a silence. There should be no noise. Otherwise, there will be no effective communication. Again, as a sender, you should ask the question that you have understood or not understood. So checking for the understanding, your face should be smiling face. And up till now, what we have learned, you should summarize. Then encouragement to continue, ask some questions. With all these parameters, with all these, if you use all these parameters, you will do an effective communication. Have understood up till now? So these are the different ways for an effective communication skill. Then next important thing, what are the barriers of an effective communication skill? Language barrier. So many, myself, I have learned from a Marathi medium. My English is not so fluent. So that the thing, there is language barrier. I cannot understand that in English pictures, English, because that's so fast. Like that, that's the barrier and I accept it. Second, noise, I have told, if the environment, there is the noise, there will be no effective communication. There are some distraction. Now you are seeing the, or listening or hearing my lecture, but still you are on a mobile, playing with a mobile. These are the distraction in day-to-day life. So seeing the WhatsApp, what are the important WhatsApp has come. So these are the distractions of the communication skill. Nowadays, if you see two friends or four friends are sitting, no one is speaking with any other. All are busy with the mobile. So that's the thing. And we are not communicating to each other. So these are the distraction and these are the major problem in day-to-day life. Then put down, you are not at all interested. Now the Anup sir has arranged this one and we PG has to sit. So like that tendency, if you are sitting, then there is lack of interest. No way, no, it will be not at all effective. So you should put interest in that topic. Disability, if the person has a disability, it's the common sense that you will not give too much attention for the communication. Discomfort with the topic. Distance, too many, so you are not able to hear. Too many questions. Other people, because sometimes what happens, there is some secret and other person is standing. You cannot communicate it to the another person what you want to say. So that person should not be present. So other person, there is time limit. So all these are the barriers of an effective communication skill. Now this is very important. Huh? So remember throughout your life that if we are supposed to talk more than listen, we would have been given 2 mouths and 1 ear. So God has given us 2 ears and 1 mouth. So naturally, what we should do? We should listen much more than speaking. But introspect yourself in day-to-day life. Are you listening too much or are you speaking too much? And for effective communication skill, listening is very important. And I have shown that slide that the listening has given 45% weightage in a communication. And listening is a skill. Listening is a skill. And any skill can be improved with a practice. So remember that. So listening is a skill and any person can improve that listening skill with a practice. So remember this. And if you are very fond of to read motivational books and you have read many motivational books, there are this sentence that if you want to successful in your life, you should listen much more. So listening is very important. Next, my question is, what is the difference between listening and hearing? Pallavi Joshi, what is the difference between listening and hearing? Pallavi, please tell the answer.
Yes, hello, sir. So the basic difference between listening and hearing is that while listening, we need to basically understand the person, like whatever the person is saying, whereas hearing is when mostly it's superficial. Like we are not really understanding what the person has to say. So okay. Listening has more meaning than what hearing is.
Good, good. So hearing versus listening. Hearing is a physical process, natural and passive. And listening is physical as well as mental process. So you hear first, then you interrupt. That's the basic difference between the hearing and the listening. And is the active person active and it's the learned process. So what is in hearing is a physical, only physical, that there is noise. You are not paying attention, but something you are hearing. And it's natural and it's passive. While listening is physical as well as mental process, is active, learned process, and it is a skill. And again, I'm saying that listening is hard. Level of the listening. So there are 4 types of the listeners, the non-listeners, the marginal listeners, evaluative listener, and the active listener. I can give you example, and with this example, you will better understand what are the non-listeners. There are some students in your batch that kuch bhi karo, they will not come to the lecture. So these are the non-listeners. The marginal listeners, they come to the lecture only for the attendance purpose, but they don't hear anything. Only for attendance purpose they come. These are the marginal. The evaluative listener, that they will listen only which is benefited to him or her. So these are the evaluative listener. An active listener, they will listen whatever it is benefited or not, but they will actively listen each and everything. So with this example, you will better understand what are the non-listeners, what are marginal listeners, what are evaluative listeners, and what are the active listener. Listening is a skill. Active listening, I already told, when you are listening, you should actively listen. Then you have to respond. Yes, someone is telling, then you have to give the response. Otherwise, what happened in day-to-day life? Someone is speaking and you are busy with mobile. You are not responding at all to him. So that's not the thing. For a proper or effective listening, you have to respond. Then paraphrasing. If you are not clear, then you can say that, sir, or in your language, you what you want or what you want to say is like this. In your language, you can tell. That is paraphrasing. Or if you are not at all understood, you can ask the question to the sender or that who is communicating with you. By asking question, you can clear your doubts and mirroring the other's language. So these are the, with these things, you can do active listening. So there are 9 steps. So what are the 5 basic reasons we do not listen? I already told, listening is a hard work. We want only to speak. We don't want to listen anybody. So listening is a hard work. And again, I'm repeating, if you want to successful as a professional life or in your family life or in your other in society life, you must be skill yourself in a listening. So though it is hard work, you can improve. Competition, today's competition. So with this, we don't listen anybody. We also listen our parents also, our teachers also. Then rush of action, speed difference. So what is the 120 words per minute? We can speak in a 1 minute, only 120 minutes. But we can hear 360 words per minute. So nature has given that we can hear 360 words per minute. So we should listen properly and we should speak less. So that the nature has given and lack of training. So 9 steps of effective listening are face the speaker and maintain eye to eye contact. Now I am seeing many videos that some person not at all seeing the screen, they are busy with mobile or other work. So whenever you are listening, you should face the speaker and maintain eye to eye contact. Then and then only you can do the active listening. Be attentive, but be relaxed. Keep an open mind to speaker's message. Try to feel that what speaker is feeling. Listen to the words and try to picture what the speaker wants to say. Do not interrupt and do not impose your solutions. Wait for the speaker to pause to ask clarifying questions. Give the speaker regular feedback. And I also request all of you, afterwards, you have to give the feedback and give a proper or true feedback about my lecture. Pay attention to non-verbal cues, tone of voice, inflection, facial expression, gesture, postures, etc. Be aware of a potential barrier. We have seen all the potential barrier of an effective communication skill. So what are the barriers in effective communication skill? These are related to the communicator. And barriers are related to the receiver also. First, we will see the barriers related to the communicator. What? That communicator is unwillingness to say things differently. That lecture, and he is delivering that lecture for many batches, same PPTs, same thing. So there is nothing different. Unwillingness to new approaches. So in each lecture, you have to add something, new approach, new innovative things in your lecture. Then the interest will be there. Then that communicator is lack of self-confidence, lack of enthusiasm, voice quality is not clear, is prejudice, lack of feedback, and lack of motivation and training. So these are the barriers related to the communicator. And the barriers are related to the receiver. What are the barriers related to the receiver? Selective perception, very important. So those which are the benefit to me, that only I can listen. But it should not be like this. Unwillingness to change. My aisa hu, my aisi hu. I'm not going to change at all. So that is the unwillingness to the change. Lack of interest in that topic. Prejudice and belief system. Personal value system. And other internal and external factors. These are the barriers related to the receiver. Then constraints of the communication. So here you cannot do this. There are, as a human being, we have some individual difference. We don't like any other person. So we are not going to listen that. These are the some constructs of the communication. Cultural diversity. So here again, I will give the example. If the foreigner comes, or the person from USA or UK, how they meet? They hug their self. So that, but in India, that's not the culture. Our culture that anybody we meet, we do the namaste. So that is our culture. We are not going to hug everybody. So that's the cultural constraint. The legal obligation. There are some legal obligations. We cannot speak. For example, that I'm doing my sonography practice and I have legal obligation that I should not disclose the sex of a fetus. But if I say that I have to communicate that what is the sex, then it's not legally permitted. So there are the legal obligations also. So we have to follow the legal obligation, anti-discrimination, there are privacy laws, code of conduct of the organization. We have to follow in which organization we are as an employer, that we have to follow code of conduct of the organization. Confidentiality and gossip. As a doctor, because patient comes to you or a student comes to you, tell his or her personal problem to you, you should make that as a confidential. You should not gossip. And we all like a gossiping. And gossiping should be avoided and seeking advice. So these are the constraints of the communication. How do you establish more rapport? You can establish more rapport by increasing our self-confidence, understand people, be enthusiastic. There must be eye-to-eye contact and you must be interested in them. Can you hear?
Yes, sir.
Am I audible? Can you hear properly?
Yes, sir.
So, for establishing rapport, you should have self-confidence. You should understand people. You must be enthusiastic. And there must be eye-to-eye contact. And you must be interested in other people. Remember, if you have read motivational book, you should always, for a communicator, you give the importance to the other person. If you have given importance to the other person, to the student, to the patient, then he will listen to you carefully. Then types of a body language. So remember mnemonic people. P stands for posture and gesture. E stands for eye contact. O stands for orientation. P stands for presentation. L stands for looks. And E for expression of emotion. So for a posture, how do you use your hand gesture, your stance? So that are the very important while doing the communication. There should be eye-to-eye contact. There should be, you should position yourself properly. You should deliver your message with a proper presentation. And you should look decently, wear a decent clothes. And expression, facial expression should be given much more important. So these are the important related to the body language and remember these mnemonic people. This is my last slide. And I'll ask the question to Salim Sheikh. What you understood the word apathy? What is apathy? What do you understood by the word apathy? You are from which college, Salim?
Hello, yes, sir.
You are from which college?
Sir, I am from VK Patil Physiotherapy College.
VK Patil Physiotherapy. Abhi ye dala hai kya? Are you listening?
Yes, sir.
So tell me the meaning of the word apathy. What do you understood by the word apathy?
Lack of feeling and feeling. Sir, it's like a lack of feeling or lack of.
Shruti Vambore. Yes, what is apathy? Shruti? Shruti?
Hello, sir. Am I audible?
So apathy is a lack of feeling or
passion. Yes, yes.
So apathy is a lack of feeling or of compassion to a towards a person.
Padmavati, Dr. Padmavati, what is sympathy? Dr. Padmavati?
Hello? So,
yes. What is sympathy? What do you understand by the word sympathy?
Sympathy is having a feeling about the problem or patient's any problem.
You're not audible.
Hello? Hello?
Bolo abhi.
So having a feeling or showing some feelings about the patient's problem.
Okay. What is empathy? Aishwarya, Ramraji, what is empathy?
Sir, empathy is understanding the feelings, like able to understand someone's feelings and show, like share, able to share emotions.
Can anybody with an example explain these three words? What is apathy, sympathy, empathy? So I will explain by giving the example. What is apathy, what is sympathy, and what is empathy? If there is one beggar is there, you are walking on a street and you have seen a beggar, and there is in that lady, there is one small child is on her tap, and she is crying. Apathy, you are saying, oh, India hai, isme hota hai, bahut bhikari log hai. That is apathy. So what? He is seeing the beggar, and the beggar is crying, and you are walking, and you are seeing that beggar, and then you are giving your comments. Ye to India hai, isme yahi, I say bahut beggar hai. Like that. That is apathy. Sympathy, you will go and see what happened, why you are crying. So you are saying, okay, it's very sad, like that. And empathy is that you are putting yourself, why she is crying, what is her problem, how I can help her to solve her problem, that is empathy. So as a doctor, as a teacher, if you are empathetic with your student, if you are empathetic with your patient, then you will do an effective communication with them. Always be empathetic. So what is empathy? Empathy, apathy, at all non-concerned. You are not at all concerned to anybody. Sympathy, you are giving or showing the mercy to the person. And empathy is that you are putting yourself in the shoes of that person, or you are feeling what that other person is feeling. So that is the empathy. So always as a doctor, as a teacher, you should be empathetic. You should be empathetic to your student, with your patient. And how you will practice? It's very difficult, because a nice words are here or are nice to hear, but very difficult to follow in your day-to-day life. So how you are going to follow empathetically with? Always remember, if the patient is of an elder age of you, then feel that he is your father. If male, if he is female, your mother. If he or she is of a less age than you, your brother or sister. Are you going to give treatment to your father like that? Are you going to give treatment to your mother like that? Are you going to speak with that, like a brother to that person, or like that sister to that? If you feel like that, and if you do like this day-to-day practice, you will be effective in your communication as well as in your professional life. So always be empathetic. And the summary of my today's lecture is that effective communication skill, there are, it's the process, it requires two, that is, one is sender and one is receiver. And that message, sender should give or deliver that message properly by using proper words, voice, tone, expression. And receiver should listen, not hear. Listen carefully with that lecture. Whatever the sender want to give the message, attentively and interrupt properly. Understood? So these are the important things. There are some barriers of the communication skill. There are some how you can do the effective communication skill by the eye-to-eye contact, by using proper language, by using proper expression, by using proper posture. So with this, you can do effective or send your message to the receiver. So understand, there is the two things, sender and receiver. And message should be the properly sent and proper received by the receiver. So then and then only there will be the effective communication skill. As a doctor, as a teacher, you have to do the communication with your student, with your patient, with your relatives, and with the other your colleague, seniors. So for that, I have given you one method that you should be the empathetic. And if you are empathetic, you can do the proper communication skill. And remember my last sentence of this, my session, that if you are able to do the effective communication to all the stakeholders or all in your all the aspects of your life, like that of your personal life, your family life, your professional life, you if you are able to do the effective communication, you will be 100% successful in your life. That's the thing. And I'm again very thankful to Honorable Dr. Deputy Director Dr. Abhijit Dute sir, then Principal Dr. Shyam Ganvir sir, Organizing Secretary Dr. Swarna Ganvir ma'am, and Organizing Coordinator Dr. Deepak Anup sir for giving me the opportunity. And any questions, you can ask any questions for the clarification. I'm waiting for your questions. Yes, any question? Okay. No question. Hello. Means you have understood all the things or you have not understood at all. So I don't know. Yes?
Sir, there is one question that you had enumerated four types of listener.
Okay. Bolo, bolo.
Yeah, so in which category we will a smart listener, in which category it will come?
Active listener, active listener. You should be always active listener.
Okay.
Thank there you, are sir. Marginal listener, non-listeners, evaluative listener, and active listener. You should be always active listener. So, why this active listener? Because any person in your professional life, or you can get a positive thing from that person. Although from your department or clerk from your department or your colleague, some good qualities are there in every person. So you should take a positive thing from every person. So you should be the active listener. So any other question? Okay, thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Dr. Sandeep Kadu, sir. Indeed, it was a very interesting lecture. We learned so many new things about communication. And I hope every participant will start communicating with the other people. And I hope not only in the teaching, these communication skills will help, but in normal day-to-day life also, these guidelines you told about communication, they are going to help our participants. Thank you very much, sir, for sharing your valuable time with us.
Thank you.